QuadJacks TV. Frank Kassela, two-time bracelet winner, I believe.
Yes.
And WSOP Player of the Year, I want to say 2010?
Yes.
Wonderful.
And 2012.
And 2012.
Yes.
That's pretty good. Frank, great to have you. Thanks for stopping by. I believe, you know, we've known each other for a while.
Yes.
You know, we met in 2010.
Yes.
I don't think I've ever interviewed you before, have I?
I don't think so. I don't know. I mean, maybe you did on the phone. Was I, when you guys were doing the live feed after Black Friday, did I not?
Did we have you on?
I don't know.
We might have.
I know I was listening a lot,
okay.
At least. That was, you did that marathon. How long were you on the air?
Well, we were on for like a week straight.
Yeah, that
live,
was crazy.
Without interruption. The first night when we went live, I stayed awake for 60 hours nonstop.
Holy cow, I am just too old for that.
Started
no
Friday night and collapsed on Monday afternoon.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
That's what I remember from that period.
Yeah,
what about yourself?
Imagine. Well, I just remember, specifically I don't remember what I was working on. I know that I had some work-related stuff that was going on, and then with Black Friday stuff, it was just interesting, you know, to be able to pull it up on the computer and be listening to you guys and what everybody had to say about that while I was, you know, typing away on spreadsheets or whatever. Like mm-hmm. I said, specifically, I don't even remember what project I was working on, not that anybody would care, but it was good information, and I enjoyed, you know, being able to log on and listen to you guys there. It was pretty cool.
Have you played a lot of online poker?
When
it was real?
No. I was never really, you know, I would, the only time I would play online poker, there were obviously some of the really giant tournaments that, you know, where you're just getting so much for your money, I would end up logging on and playing those. But, you know, other than just trying out different lines of betting and, you know, different type of ranges of starting hands and specifically going on there to experiment, there wasn't a lot of online play that I did.
You know, a lot of people looked at last year's World Series of Poker, which came right after Black Friday, and it was, I think, one of the healthiest World Series that they ever had. This year, though, there's a lot of talk that we may be beginning to see the impact of Black Friday right now, 1 year later, on this World Series of Poker. What do you think, as a live pro, what have you seen in the live arena here at the World Series of Poker and elsewhere as a result of Black Friday?
Well, I mean, I just think that the biggest challenge that you've got is the physical moving away of the young online professionals simply from Las Vegas and from the United States in general. And, you know, I was having a conversation with Sean Deeb the other day, and I know that he said a lot of the friends that he has that live outside of the country now, they just decided not to even come up for the World Series.
Really?
Yeah, because I guess between... you know, the action that they get online, and a lot of, I guess, the tougher, you know, online players do fly to Vegas. None of them are going to be able to play, or I guess legally play or whatever. I don't even know how all that stuff works with the internet. So competition gets thinner, and it's just a good opportunity for them to stay where they're at and play.
What about your World Series of Poker this year? How's it been so far?
Good. I think I've played 10-ish events, and I've got... two really deep finishes. I had a 14th place finish in the 1500 stud 8 or better. I think we had a field of about 600 or 700 people.
Mm-hmm.
And then last night I finished 15th in the six-handed event, the 1500 buy-in six-handed, and we had I don't remember, over 1500 right. people in that. So they're both, you know, they're both those heartbreaking spots to get to, though, to get that deep in a big tournament and end up right before the final table busting out.
All right, so it may not have gone completely your way back there, but am I not correct? You and Todd Brunson were in the lead in Daniel Negreanu's 25K final? Yes, all right.
I think we're ahead by 1 point right now. We had three people hit our board yesterday. I collected points, Bill Helmuth collected points, and Todd coming in second place collected a bunch of points, and we took a 1 point lead.
I guess you guys who participated, like, did you follow that pretty constantly or as much as you can throughout the series? Because, I mean, it is a lot of money, and, you know,
yeah.
You stay on it.
Heck yeah, awesome. Yeah. Not only is it a lot of money, it's just a lot of fun. It's a cool, different way to do it, and I guess there's other online things you can do with Fantasy League and stuff like that. I just think that makes the World Series a lot more fun.
Okay. I want to ask you a question, because, you know, we were at the draft. It was also, like, a lot of fun to be there and do the auction. I've been wondering about this, because I'm new to any kind of draft, really, and I want to ask you this. Is there any benefit, like, let's say you're down to your last 24 points or so, right? Like, to bid on someone. And, you know, and you've committed yourself to a player, and you're going to, well, you start 18, 19, 20. Is there any benefit, as I heard it all day, to say like, you know, 24 all in, is there any benefit in declaring that you're all in, kind of like you would in poker, but when you're doing a draft?
Well, do you mean in a way where other people have more points than you?
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, because I'm just thinking like, you know, why would you, I mean, maybe your opponents are probably keeping track of it, but why would you just tell the person who is bidding against you that like all they have to do is just bid on one more point and they've ruined it? It's not like poker where like they get, that's kind of like a string bet,
right?
Example of a string bet in the draft for me, you know?
Like in our case in particular, Todd and I actually did that very thing at the very end of the draft. We had 45 points left. We had one slot left. Nobody else had more than maybe 32 points, I think, left to spend. And we just decided we wanted Lissandro as our last pick, and rather than waste anybody's time, we just said, yep, Lissandro, 45.
And that's more like shoving, but like I'm saying, if it's been kind of like, you know, a gradual, you know, surge.
But if you're
know,
in a spot where you're curious. Bidding on somebody and then there's some extra points on another team where they could actually outbid you, then you're really only doing it, I guess, at that point to maybe save time by saying, okay, this is our guy, we're interested in him, we're willing to spend all of our points on him.
See, I thought that, like, you may want to give your opponent the lasting impression that, you know, he'll never know how far you're willing to take this. If he's forgotten that you're running low on points, you know, he might be discouraged to keep baiting. Just like, well, it looks like Frank wants this guy very badly.
You're 100% right. Yeah. You're 100% right. You know, from a psychological point of view, you probably should do it that way, especially at that point in the draft where we've already invested a couple of hours, you know, to take an extra minute or two to maybe make sure you get that person and not, you know, not give away to somebody else that, you know, that's the spot that you're in. That's probably smart. But, you know, I don't think we thought that much about it. In our case, nobody could outbid us anyway, so that's how we ended up with our team.
You guys have a very strong team.
I like our team. We got everybody we wanted. There's only one spot, I think, where we weren't really sure, but I think we like our team.
Listen, Mr. Kassela, Frank, it's been wonderful to speak to you finally. I've really enjoyed this interview. I hope we'll be able to do this more often.
All right.
You know, stop by. We'll
I'll
be here
around.
At this table. Okay?
All
good
right.
luck to you, sir.
All right. Thank you. Y'all have a good day.
Frank Kassela.